name is Dave Rhines. I work at Bluehost. I wanted to say a big thank you to the WordCamp Boston Organizing Committee for having me up here to talk about custom WP-CLI commands. So before we dive in, who here has used WP-CLI before? Good, so a big chunk. Who here has built a custom WP-CLI command? Alright, hopefully we can get those hands raised by the end of this. So, some of my favorite quotes. Any sufficiently advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. When I started using WP-CLI, I said, these things are so powerful, they're so useful, they must be really complicated, they must be really difficult to write. But they're actually surprisingly approachable to build. I wouldn't call them easy, but they're very approachable to build. It's more like building a simple circuit than it is building a rocket. So what is WP-CLI? Really quick for anyone in the room who hasn't used WP-CLI. So CLI stands for Command Line Interface. And the WP-CLI is a way to interact with WordPress from the command line on your computer as opposed to a graphic user interface in a web browser. So on the left, we're probably familiar with the standard WordPress post list in the admin. And if I were to run the WP post list command, I would get a kind of similar list in my terminal showing me the output. So it's kind of like a chat bot. So if you've used Slack, if you've used an automated assistant, it's sending it a prompt, sending it a keyword right here. We're texting Domino's a pizza emoji and having it run our order. And WP-CLI is going to be very similar. We give it these custom commands, or core commands that come with it. So WP-post-list, here I tell it I want JSON, and it's going to, instead of giving me that nice boxed layout, it's going to actually give me that return as JSON. And here I said, you know what, I actually want it as a comma separated value. So it's going to give me a CSV instead. So WP-CLI comes with 44 commands out of the box to interact with WordPress. You can interact with posts, pages, users, anything you can do in the WordPress admin, you can do with WP-CLI. So what are some of the benefits of WP-CLI? So one of the main ones is that it is chainable and composable. What I mean by that is that you can have commands chained together. So you can say, you know, do this, then do that, and then do this. So go update some posts, go update some users, go update some options. Or you can compose them together so that the results of one command are used in the next. So if I wanted to find all of the drafts for a user in WordPress, in the WordPress admin I can go and click and see all of the posts from a user, or I can go and click and see all the drafts on the site. But you actually can't see all of the drafts for one user on the site. So if you run a big like news website, or you're blogging really frequently, you share that site with a lot of other users, might not be able to find a list of all of those posts. So by using WP-CLI, I could make a command to go and query all the posts for a user, and then limit them only to drafts. So chainable and composable, we'll look at a few other examples of that in a minute. There's built-in help. So whenever you're using a tool, you're often flipping back and forth between the manual and the tool itself. One of the really nice things about WP-CLI is that all of the documentation is baked into the tool itself. So if you type WP help in any command in WP-CLI, whether that is a core command or a custom command, that will surface the documentation for that command right in the interface. And you can use that help positional argument, or you can use the flag argument of dash dash help. For multi-site, things that might take a few minutes that you cut down to a few seconds for a single site. Something that might take you a few minutes on multi-site multiplied by, say, 200 or 300 sites is going to take you hours to do manually. So some of the real power of WP-CLI is in WordPress multi-site. Any kind of task you're doing in multi-site is probably going to be made a lot simpler with WP-CLI. And last, one of the main benefits of WP-CLI is that you can use it to remote control another instance of WP-CLI. So you can use your local install of WP-CLI to control your production environment, your staging environment, or other servers elsewhere. If you are an agency or you manage a lot of sites, you can set up aliases for each of your sites and remote control all of your WordPress sites from one place. So we also looked at this a little bit earlier, but one of the other things I wanted to highlight is the format helper. Part of the reason I wanted to highlight this is that this is something that you can use in custom commands that you build. So this format JSON or format CSV, you'll see in a lot of the core commands. And if you want to create a command that can output to multiple data types, whether that's a table, JSON, or CSV, that's something you'll be able to reuse in WP-CLI. And then, highly flexible. When you're a developer, it's really great to have multiple ways to do one thing, and I think that's one of the great advantages of WP-CLI. It's a little tough to see here, sorry, but here I'm running a WP option update for WordCamp is awesome. Then a WP eval, which lets me execute PHP inside the command line. You could also use a WP DB query to just write a MySQL query directly, or I could write a custom command. So what are some practical uses for custom commands? Well, you can use WP-CLI to fully install WordPress, download it, and then set up your WP config file, set up your default user and your site name. You can also use it to set up WordPress. And so I guess the distinction I would make there is installing WordPress, you're probably going to set up a config file, you're going to set up some basic details about your site. Maybe you're using a local development environment, it already sets WordPress up for you to a baseline, but you might want to delete all the default themes. You might want a set of core development plugins anytime you spin up a site in Lando or Local by Flywheel or Desktop Server. You can also use WP-CLI to run updates. This is really handy if you set up aliases for all of your sites. You can say WP at all update. Plugins or core or something to that effect. You need to set an application state. So one thing that we're often doing as developers if we're writing code is that we are working on maybe step 3 of 5 of a setup process or a checkout process, whatever we're working on. And if we're constantly spinning up new environments and just going and setting those things manually, having something that can sort of just automatically always set you up to step 2 of your onboarding, or step 4 or 10, is really, really helpful. Time-based tasks. So one of the advantages of WP-CLI is that you could have your server cron run WP-CLI. So if you say wanted to run updates every hour, you could just set a cron job to go and run updates. But it's also just great if you have to go fetch external data and you write a command to do that. You can attach it to server cron and have it execute. Great for external APIs and connecting with other applications. So if you wanted to connect to, say, a security database and scan all your files in WordPress, you could make a connection in WP-CLI, go out and scan all your files. Another common use I've seen it for, I used to work in publishing, so plagiarism is a big thing in media publishing. So if you go and type out all of your post content to a plagiarism checker service, and then maybe run that service, you know, once a day or something, that's another really great use. You can make some custom import and export commands for your team and your environments. Again, sort of tying in just great team and customer tools. Whether you're building for an internal client and you work on a team with multiple developers, or whether you build a product that's used by lots of other developers, building these commands really sets everyone up to use the same tools. So sometimes as developers, we'll just toss an alias in our bash profile, maybe even with some WP-CLI commands. But next time you're thinking of maybe just making an alias or making a quick shortcut to something, think about making a custom command, because that's something you can share with your team. it's more likely to be in version control than some script monkey file you have on your machine. And then it's accessible from any machine you're on. So if you're away from your machine and you're on vacation, and someone asks you to run that complicated script, you can go and download that command to whatever machine you can find. Last thing on this slide, it's great for generating new projects, so to scaffold new code. There's the WP-scaffold command that can be used to make plugins, themes, as well as WP-CLI packages. WP-CLI packages are sort of like a plugin for WP-CLI. You install them via Composer. And you don't see them in your WordPress admin, so they can be a great solution if you want to create a tool but not expose it to people in WordPress. That's a little rough to read, isn't it? Let's see. This is the hazard.
I do those columns. I don't remember looking, but they are like the rosy columns.
Yeah, the invert colors. I think I'm going to try that. Accessibility, does anyone know if it's a big shout out? There we go. That's a little easier to read. So, adding the WP-CLI command, we write these all in PHP. We might be using them in our terminal, but you can get it done in as cheap as 20 lines of code. And you can copy and paste this. I have a whole bunch of links at the end with links to this presentation and a bunch of other resources. So here I have my custom command, calling it pew pew pew, right? So if I were to go into my command prompt, type WP pew pew pew, that would run this command. Before I'm using this, I'm making sure that WP-CLI is available, and I'm returning if it isn't so that we never get to this line. If you don't do that, you'll see some really, really unfriendly fatal errors in your command prompt. So we use the static add command here, this first value. This can be your top-level command, like if you're trying to create a command for products, right? This could be products. This could also be products activate. So you can have a space in there if you wanted to include this on a subcommand. And so you could have one registration for all of your commands that fall under this, or you could say register, you know, pew 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 activate or pew 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 deactivate as separate registrations. Then there's a callback. Right here I'm just using a closure. I really recommend using a class. We'll look at that in a second. But in your callback, here in your function, you get two arrays. Your first one is called args. Your second one is called associative args. So this first one are positional arguments. So with commands, this is my command string here. Then if I had, you know, WP pew 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 1, that number 1 would be my first positional argument because it's in a position separated by a space. This associative array of arguments is going to hold both flags and associative arguments. Flags are called flags partially just because they look like a flagpole. They have a dash dash before them. So sometimes you'll see the dash dash force command. Dash dash prompt is really helpful because it will ask you about each of the commands. So here I say, delete my option called config, and then if deleted, report ah yes back to my command prompt. So if I were to type WP pew pew pew, it would say ah yes. And if it can't delete that option, it would tell me it's some bad news. Then this third parameter here is an array of options. filters, excuse me. This is just telling WordPress or WP-CLI when to run this command. So the same way we have hooks in WordPress, we have hooks in WP-CLI, and the main time you use it probably is with this before WordPress load. There are certain commands in WP-CLI where you need to have the database available and WordPress fully installed to use them. So if you need to delete an option, it needs to happen after WordPress loads. But if you want to do a WP core download to download WordPress, you have to run that command before WordPress load. Otherwise, it's going to try to find WordPress and not see it. So I'm going to try to jump back colors here really quick. So a few best practices with commands before we look.
Did I speak over them?
Yeah, I did. There we go. So in that registration, I just used an anonymous function. But I recommend using a PHP class when you write your commands. There is this sort of main class. There's not too much that happens in this core WP-CLI command class. A slash here because I'm in a namespace, so I'm trying to get back out to the namespace there. You want to use, try to extend off this class because if anything ever does happen in there, you want to inherit that into your command. And here I just have an abstract base class. Part of the reason I wanted to show this is that this start command and this stop command, because or a function, because they're public, automatically get registered as commands. So if I say WP-CLI add command, and I add this base class, whatever I added to, if it was that pew pew pew, this would be pew 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 start and pew 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 stop automatically. So anytime you create a public function in a class, it's automatically turned into a command. Now a protected function in a class, you can't use private, it has to be protected or public. This protected function is really great for helpers, because I can't type helper and run this function, but I can then use this function in my other commands. So if you're trying to split code, it's just a nice way to organize your code and your data. So I'll just say, yeah, so.
Sorry, just real quick to clarify, the class there, when you do that, then if you replace the function call, even that the slide before this?
Yeah, so instead of function here, my class here is space, right, space base. So I would put space base here in a string, as opposed to putting that function there. And then that would run, it could be anything. It could be a function, you could have a named function, a global namespace here, or it could be a class.
Okay.
Yep.
What's up?
What's that here?
That's right.
What, it looks like you're standing at their class. This one's on three. Why is that the abstract?
It doesn't have to be. I'm just trying to point out that this is a great way to sort of make this is a great way to sort of organize some helpers and then extend that whenever you make a command. So you're probably going to find once you make one command, you're going to want to make more. So I recommend making some kind of base class that has whatever helpers and utilities you need in your other commands. And then anything that can be shared, try to put in that base class. And then anything you want to put in a command like this, you can just extend off that. So some best practices when we're designing a CLI. I think it's easy to forget that we're actually doing some design here. We're not making a GUI, but we still are sort of creating workflows and user experience. So whenever you make a custom command, you want to try to do one thing. And when you do it really well. Be very flexible, have multiple parameters to change the format, maybe accept different types of data, maybe accept an integer and a string or multiple types of data. You want to try to keep your commands discrete so that you can compose and chain them together. Then if you need to combine multiple commands that do one thing, make a sort of wrapper command that is going to go and execute each of those commands. Because you can run WP-CLI commands from inside other WP-CLI commands. So try to focus on doing one thing and then creating a wrapper for multi-step things. You want to be consistent and parallel in your naming of things. So if you have a method called start, you probably want a method called stop, not end. So try to keep things matching. So start and stop, begin and end, as opposed to intermixing those. You also, I guess that's the parallels, you want them to start and stop and end. You also want to be trying to avoid jargon in your command names. So you don't want to call something WP process billing objects, right? If there's something that you're calling the data type in the command, that's probably better as a type doc than in the command. Same thing with an API. If you're saying, you know, hit this API, then go do this, then go do that, you're probably naming your command too long. That's not something you're going to want to type. It's not something anyone else is going to want to type either. So try to keep those in the docs or in the help for your command, but not in the actual command string. You don't want to reinvent the wheel or the wheels. There's a lot of CLIs out there. You might use one for your local development environment. You might use other CLIs on your team, like NPM, Composer. So try to mimic things that your team might already be comfortable with when you're designing this, or customers might already be comfortable with, as opposed to going out and inventing something new for the sake of it. When we're building these commands, we want to build them for people, but these are also executed by machines, and this is a tricky balance. So in a CLI, you might want to add some interactivity, like ask a question, like, are you sure you want to do this? Or, you know, pick from these options, I want to build. When you do that, you're actually throwing up another hurdle for yourself if you want to go and automate that task. So whenever you throw up some kind of interactivity prompt in a command, ideally you want to make some other kind of argument that lets someone preset that so that you can bypass that interactive bit and just execute the command without having to have a machine go through an interactive prompt. So when CLIs were first made, in particular, you had to be very brief with your labeling. So that's why we have a lot of commands like make dir, mkdir. We have all these really short commands. We don't need to do that anymore. We have plenty of processing power in our machines. So if you're leaning towards making like a really short command name, or being really brief in an argument, probably want to fully extend that out to something that is short enough that it's not a pain to write or type, but long enough that it really explains itself and someone doesn't have to go check the docs. So if you have a flag that's just flag I instead of flag interactive, I would lean more towards interactive, even though it's got a bunch more characters. Now if you're going to add interactive, you know, sequence or something much longer, so try to find that balance in between making something clear, legible, and making something clear. So reusing WP-CLI commands in your commands is going to save you a lot of time. So if you are building an installer command, you don't have to go and, you know, read a file and write and all these, you know, steps. Look for opportunities where you can just use the core commands run them inside your command. Some of my favorite commands I've written are really just running a sequence of WP-CLI commands. So you don't have to really break new ground. And if you can't really think of, you know, a crazy command to make, you're like, all right, well, they look easy enough to build, but what am I going to build? What are things we do every day, like installing WordPress or setting up WordPress a specific way or downloading a specific set of plugins or themes? So look for opportunities to those. And finally, you want to be trying to write some functional tests. WP-CLI uses something called BHAP, and there's actually a command where you can scaffold tests for your custom command. So whether you're creating a package or a plugin, you can go and scaffold out some of those tools for yourself. So I want to do a quick live demo. first thing I wanted to show is that I have a repo with a bunch of resources for learning WP-CLI, as well as starting to write your own custom commands. So if any of this is going too quick, or you're like, I don't even know what the command line is, I have an So there's an introduction to WP-CLI in this folder. There's an introduction to command line if you're new to WP-CLI. Then what you probably came for is learning about how to build some custom commands. So some benefits, some ideas that I had mentioned for some custom commands. You can build these in plugins. You must use WordPress plugin or a WP-CLI package. Some of the pros and cons of both. So some more examples of how you use add command. You can either do this class exists check, or you can hook into CLI init, and then that will include this check in it. So if you want to just sort of start running your command right away and call back, you would add to CLI init, add my custom command, register your custom command. So this is, again, called the command name. You have this callable argument and an optional argument of optional array of arguments. So I could have add command magic that handles start and stop. I could have magic start and I call back that handles just start. I have magic stop, call back that handles stop. Some details in here about positional arguments and associative arguments. These are just arrays, but one thing I will point out is if you're working with flags or associative arguments, there is this getFlagValue command. Instead of checking if an array key exists, some kind of isSet or array key exists, and just accessing that value directly, recommend using this getFlagValue. There is a global flag called quiet that someone can use to try to turn off verbose output in your command. And if you use this getFlagValue, it will respect that basically from adding more logs as you write. So you want to try to use this as opposed to just accessing that array key directly. We're starting to look at some of this, how whenever you register a class name, you can have a start and stop. But you can also use this invoke. Note that this isn't construct. Construct won't work here. But if you have your class in invoke, you have access to any of the positional or associative arguments that came there. And then I could have cool start and begin run the same method. So if you want to sort of predict ahead of some of your team and you're always typing plugins, but really it's plugin, this is another little simple trick to have both of those things go and do the same thing. Talked briefly about the WP-CLI hooks. Here are some of those other hooks. Before add command, before invoke. So you can have code that runs before your command, maybe go and check for dependencies before that command goes and tries to use them. The PHP doc parser is what grabs all of the comments above your function or class and then turns those into those in-app help documentation. So I definitely recommend looking at the WP-CLI documentation standards page. If you follow that, all of your documentation will just magically be inside of your commands. So some other things in this repo, some best practices, we talked about those a little bit, but I go into a little bit more depth here. Command should be one thing, be verbose. The main things I wanted to look at briefly in this last few minutes is just this My Resources page. So an example of a custom WP-CLI command to go and install WordPress. This is a command that I use with Lando. So in here I have a command called install. I go and I check first if a value is passed as the first positional argument or as a flag argument for URL. Basically just doing some validation here to make sure someone passed a URL, site URL is required. Once I'm ready to go, I handle my install. And then here, I'm updating WP-CLI using this run command from WP-CLI. Then core download, I'm making a config file, Lando's database credentials and database details are all the same. Then I'm running a core install here with the URL, the title. Site empty will delete all of the default Hello World data from your WordPress site. So you can get a really clean site right out of the gate. Site empty and then widget reset all, wipe out all of the default taxonomies, all the default post data. I'm going to create a user for myself, set permalinks how I like them, flush those rewrites, delete some of the default plugins, update some options, update my time zone, something I always forget to do, and then I'm trying to debug time issues, and it's like, oh yeah, I should probably set my time zone when I like set up the site. And then here, I'm just imploding an array of developer plugins, just some plugins I like to use, and then I'm activating them. So there's that list of plugins up here. So here's some ideas or some patterns that you could use as you're creating an installer. So this link is in there. Something I've been working on is a extendable replicator. So if you're trying to go and build your own code scaffolding tool, the scaffold commands are great. Unfortunately, they rely on the WP file system classes inside WordPress. So if you wanted to go and generate a command like the one we just looked at that installs WordPress, you could use that command. But if you wanted to generate that, you would have to have WordPress already installed to go and generate an install command. So this has no dependencies on WordPress 4. So you can set it up with some mustache templates that describe how your template, or your theme, or your plugin should look. And then you can just write those out into the WP-CLI. If you're trying to add some more advanced formatting or interactivity, maybe some animation to your commands, again, be careful with some of those if you're doing anything you want to be scriptable. But CLI Mate is a really great tool from PHP League. It throws up really great ways to format colors, put everything in a table, dump some data out to your command line. But it also gives you some more interactive tools like checkboxes and multi-selects. So if you're familiar with a lot of JavaScript installers will let you select multiple items from a list or just get a list of checkboxes. So CLI Mate is a PHP tool that does that. I'll also point you to Pascal, I think it's Bircher. He has a post called An Introduction to WP-CLI he wrote earlier this year that's really great. And then John Blackburn and Elaine have some really good talks on WP-CLI, why you want to use it, and some interesting use cases for using it. So I think we're basically out of time, but do we have any questions?
Yeah, so you mentioned testing. Is there a particular framework or something that you find has worked really well for specifically CLI stuff?
Yeah, so if you were, so if you go to the WP-CLI org on GitHub, any of the core commands are here in a repo, and they're a really great jumping off place to look at how these BCAT tests work. So any of these .feature files are going to be a test, and they basically are very verbose. They describe sort of what should be happening. So a scenario, help should be displayed. So given that WordPress is installed and I run this command, save standard output as plugin. So it gives you an idea of how you might start writing these.
I might sound real dumb. You said B app.
Yes.
That's the testing toolkit.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
So there's this bhat YAML config file in here that tells it where the features are. And then look in Composer here. There's some scripts here to show how to run the bhat tests. And under the scaffold command, there actually are subcommands in there that will generate these tests for you. All right, any other questions? Yeah?
You mentioned there's a config option to tell your command at what point of the cycle, what cycle to run.
Yep.
I was just wondering, what's the default? You don't specify when does it run.
The default is after WordPress is loaded. So after the full bootstrap is run, and all of the constants are set, like apps path, WP content dir, all that. So,
thanks.
All right, I'll be at the happiness bar all afternoon if anyone has any other questions. And thanks for having me.